Peace, shalom. It's Tata Doc and Rhea. I'm back again. I'm going to let her start this off. So, that being said, oh, by the way, I would like to just tell you, this is not legal advice. We do not work for legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself competent counsel and please be advised. What we're about to give you just for education and information and entertainment purposes only. So, that being said,
pretty much going to be talking about how there's a lot of people out there who are not very forthcoming with their services in terms of helping or providing a service in terms of trying to get their secured party creditor packets processed properly and efficiently. And it seems like there's been a lot of animosity out there with people who are getting screwed. So that's going to be an issue, and so that's a lot of people are upset about that.
With that being said, as you all may have known or you may have heard, a lot of people is actually giving money to this brother for life, and he has not rendered his services. Pharaoh Allah, young Pharaoh, to actually put out a video on that, exposing the fraud. And, you know, the Amin Ra squad came out with a video in defense of their humble brother, Polite. But the fact of the matter is this. If you're doing an injustice to the people, that particular injustice needs to be pointed out. So that people, that person would actually have the opportunity to repent, go back, and undo the wrong that he's done. So the rightful act that this brother could do is either stop offering his services or refund the money or go back and do those people's documents and give them somewhat of a refund for the delay in time. That's just justice right there. But with us, it's quid pro quo, something for something. So for the time, energy, and effort put forth in the research, you get what you've actually asked for. But a key factor to remember is that it's actually your responsibility to ensure that your documents is processed properly once you receive those documents. I cannot overemphasize that. If you do not follow instructions well, then you may have problems or complications. If you follow instructions correctly, you're not going to have a problem. That's crystal clear. Any other questions? That's it? Is that one question? Are you kidding? Come on, you got something. I mean, something else regarding something. Come on.
I think.
Don't get Mike shy now.
Oh, I know. I think a lot of people are trying to just get the secured party creditor, squared away, just because a lot of, like you said, a lot of people are getting screwed and things like that. And really, the least thing the people can do is refund their money back, or at least provide a remedy, or say that that they were wrong. Because it's not working. But in terms of questions and things like that, I think one of the questions that I believe that a lot of the audience is wanting is just how to protect themselves in court when they're presented with having to be forced to be going to court when they have to have a warrant, threat from a court official saying they have to be thrown in court. These are things that people need to know in order to protect their rights, to assert their rights. I think a lot of people are probably wanting to rectify that.
Well, yeah, I mean, whenever you actually, if you receive a warrant or an offer, it's always an offer. First of all, you should actually essentially start looking at everything as if it's an offer, because that's what it is. It's an offer. So you don't want to just totally go on acquiescence, which is silent, because that's dishonor. So generally, you want to respond with a conditional acceptance and make a special appearance. You never want to appear generally in court for informational purposes. You always want to appear specially to challenge subject matter, jurisdiction, and deal with it from there. But if they can't get beyond jurisdiction, they have no case. They're hung up with jurisdiction if you proceed accordingly. One more thing that I would like to point out. Now, I know many of you out there in the listening audience would love to see Taza Dalshah go in and sit down on Seth Meador's sofa and talk contract law. For whatever reason, this man has actually been avoiding that. I don't have a clue as to why. So if you in the listening audience would like to see a contract law expert on Seth Meador's show, giving you the true, keys and rules to how the game is actually being played, then contact Seth Meador and ask him, why have you not invited Taza Doc on your show? I mean, it's a simple question. I'm not sure if it's a personal vendetta, but I've seen a lot of people just popping up out of nowhere and they're settling contract law experts, and they're saying things that I actually repeated back in 2009, 2010, and even up to some of the videos that I posted in 2011. So I'm just hearing a lot of stuff that's actually been previously repeated, but they're not giving you any real remedy. They're just pointing out things that's actually already been pointed out. So, I mean, if you'd like to see me on the show, I'd be more than happy to go in there and set the record straight on Seth Meador's show. I was looking for you on Harlem Seth Meador, but I didn't see you. You're missing in action. And the Dread told me that he seen your man's Delight in Harlem a couple days ago. But I guess he came unannounced because there's still a lot of dirt out there. You know, not too like trying to say anything negative about him. Just trying to keep it a buck, trying to keep it real. Any other questions besides that?
That was pretty much on the money. That was pretty accurate.
All right, so I mean, with that being said, we'll just bring this to a close. Again, if you have any kind of skills and you would like to become a member of the Universal Indigenous People, email creditors, debtors, contracts, and commerce. Actually, visit the website, creditors, debtors, contracts, and commerce.org. Or just email creditors, debtors, contracts at yahoo.com. With that, tell me Doc says shalom and peace. So thank you. Marianne? Oh. Hey, you ain't saying Spanish.
Maria.
Hey, say something to the Hispanic brothers and sisters out there. That bilingual, can you help? Say something in Spanish because there's probably some bilingual listeners watching, and just tell them how to go to the website and all of that. In Spanish. That's funny, yeah? No, it's good. Really?
I can't.
Well, maybe next time. She'll get back to you the next time. So, hey, if you like the video, subscribe to the channel, tell your family, tell your friends, and share the video. So, shalom. Peace.